The great thing about coming to a trade fair like Electronica is to learn about all the innovation that's been going on in the last couple of years. I'm going to talk to Nar about the new F29 microcontroller targeting real-time applications with their new C2000 core. And the great thing about this, it's got loads of functional safety support for industrial and automotive applications. Hello, Nar. It's lovely to meet you here at the Texas Instruments stand Electronica 2024. Now, I'm very, very excited to be talking to you today because I understand you're introducing a brand new real-time microcontroller. It's the F29 family. Tell me a little bit more about that microcontroller product.
Thanks for having me today. I'm very excited to introducing the new family from TI C2000 family, F29 series. Using the new CPU core of C29, it provides more than double the real-time performance of our existing devices.
Excellent. Now the C29, I was looking at the information earlier about the family. The C29 looks like a very powerful processing core. Why is it so powerful and what can it do?
It is designed based on the new VLIW architecture. It provides 8 times of instruction processing capability within every clock cycle. And you can imagine a lot of processing power, especially for real-time task.
Yeah. And that means it's also still real-time capable, really good for real-time embedded applications.
Definitely, yes. It provides more processing power for real-time tasks, more mass processing capability. Like we are showcasing, it provides 8 times processing, instruction processing capability, 5 times FFT processing speed than our previous core.
Fantastic. Now, looking around at the demos that you've got here on the show today, I've noticed that it's very much focused on industrial and automotive applications. What sort of peripherals and interfaces are on the F29 family to support applications in those markets?
Yeah, besides the C29 core design for automotive and industrial real-time control applications, it also have a rich interface, including advanced PWM, ADC, and all the standard interface for automotive, like Lean, CAN-FD, also in interface called the SENT, dedicated for motor control applications.
Yeah. Now, if we go deeper into the types of applications that are being built in automotive and industrial, there's a lot of digital conversion going on for DC-DC converters. Motor inverters are a big part of those applications, and this is where these types of microcontrollers are used. If I'm building that type of application, I need really good PWMs and integration with the ADC.
That's right.
What have you done there?
Yeah, so this PWM is our new generation, high-resolution PWM. It has 75 picosecond of resolution and highly flexible. It can be triggered 8 times within a clock cycle. So you can pretty much shape your PWM in the way you want. That can be used to really control multiple switches in the power converters and some motor algorithm that you want to really manipulate.
Yeah. Now, both of these markets also have functional safety requirements. What have you done with this particular family of microcontrollers to help engineers meet the functional safety standards?
Right, so this device provides a lockstep core capability. We have 3 CPU cores in the superset of the device, and 2 of them can be lockstep. And also we have built in error checking, many hardware features. It's a ground up design to for the latest automotive and industrial safety standard with the integrity level up to ASIL-D and CO3.
Fantastic. And there's also a module called SSU. Can you tell us a little bit more about what does that mean and what does it do?
Yes. So SSU is the safety security unit. Okay. It provides the memory protection function with the hardware isolation of the threads. So it provides freedom from interference without sacrificing the real-time performance.
Now for functional safety, that's quite a specialized area of developing an application. Do you provide some software to help engineers and design teams meet the standards and get certification?
Yes, we'll provide the software diagnostics library for customers to easily achieve the safety goal.
Now, in terms of getting started, people need a development environment, they need software libraries, they need evaluation boards. Yes. How should an engineer start with the F29 family? What do they need to download? Where do they buy the boards that are available to
come to TI.com. We'll have the software SDK, as well as MCAL drivers. And we work with third party to provide AUTOSAR support. And in terms of hardware, we have the evaluation module, we call EVM, control car, and the reference designs to showcase how to use it in a real application, like motor control, power conversion. Easy to use.
That's great news. I think it's a very exciting product. It's great to see such innovation in that very specific area, and power conversion and efficiency and functional safety together, all really important topics for automotive and industrial. So thanks for giving us this update.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.